I don't know how far away we are, but we're knocking on the door for sure. And this produces a wow. Maybe the door will open. Oh, wow. So we're standing here at the door, I've been knocking on it, and at some point just say, oh my gosh, if I keep knocking, maybe somebody's gonna actually come and open up the door. So that gets a little wowish. Yeah. Specialness, the belief in specialness, is the belief in time, space, process, form, is the belief in boundness, in moments being bound to one another. And therefore, it's the belief in staleness, in deathness. It's the belief, the anti-belief from freshness. It is that which is the belief that it, in non-freshness, right? Because moments are bound together. They're not fresh. There's not fresh freedom present. So when we say I'm totally normal, what we're saying is we're inviting in the feeling, that feeling of freshness, which only references freshness. Freshness referencing freshness. Freshness rooted in freshness. This is what's going to open the door. This is when we open the door, this is what there is there. So I was listening tonight, I was like, wow. It's a beautiful morning, think I'll go outside for a while, and just smile, drinking some clean, fresh air, clean, fresh air. Someone opened up a door for me. And I was listening to these popish songs of the 60s, the right, Young Rascals. Freshness. But that was just the freshness of youth and changing times. That was bogus. It wasn't real freshness at all. So I said, nah, that's not it. They're just talking about changing trends, which are always changing. At that time, there was a big change over from the 50s to the 60s. and the young people, you know, look very different. And so, wow, some clean, fresh air. But that's not what we're talking about, freshness. Freshness we're talking about is out of this world. It's not coming from this world, it's freshness coming from freshness. And that's all there is to it, actually. So since we're so close, we're just gonna keep going like this. It's late at night, it's absolutely still. There is not a breath of air moving anywhere. It's warm. I couldn't tell you where I am or what day, what time of year it is or anything. It's just, could be anywhere, anytime. And there's this little frog, something, some creature, right, making this wonderful little noise, summer noise. But even this is not the freshness that we're talking about. Well, I'll tell you this. It's better that it comes than it doesn't come. That's the bottom line. I'm not going to try to figure it out. I'm not going to do all the
the analytics and break it all down, and the final analysis is better that it arrives than it doesn't arrive. Because people at least will be preoccupied with this and forget about the world. Whatever conclusions, temporary conclusions they draw, it's not an easy road to getting it all clear and accepting it the way it is and all that. But it's a necessary road, and it's better than the alternative by far. It's the new era. It's the new music. Silence is the new music. Freshness is the new style. And this is just what's happening. That's all. This is what's perpetually hip, the perpetual hipness. And so, of course, people are going to be positively disturbed. I mean, there's two types of disturbance. One is the negative, one is the positive. Positive disturbance is just like throws your life into the... what is it? Disturbance, but it's all positive. It throws it into turmoil, positive turmoil. Where you say, well, it's not this, and it's not this, and it's not this. I got out with that, in with this. Yeah, I gotta somehow get aligned with this, and so yeah, it's turmoil. But that's better than just the blahs as we sink into this negative turmoil of the world. Little positive turmoil is quite welcome right now. So we'll see what happens. So I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I know I'm already successfully normal. I don't need to become successfully normal. I know I'm already successfully normal. I don't need to become successfully normal. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. People think that their lives are just going to continue on, and then something happens, and positive turmoil happens. They say, shoot, you know, what happened to my life? It just, everything's turned upside down. And this is tough. This is a challenge. But deep down they really say, you know, this is a challenge that I want. Coyotes. Hear them? Coyotes. Whatever. That's a negative turmoil. Let's do positive turmoil. Freshness, coming from freshness, freshness derived from freshness. How about that? Freshness derived from freshness. Just gonna knock us out. It is a knockout. And it's gonna be great to be knocked out. in a positive way. It's like, you know, oh, we miss the apocalypse. Oh, gee, how terrible. Oh, you know, we miss the tribulation. That's a shame. Well, maybe next time. We missed all the trouble, the suffering, the misery. You can't have everything. So we open up the door, and that's it. That's just silence. That's it. Nothing more to say. This is the freshness that comes from freshness, and that's it. From that point on, it's just wow. Then we realize this is just normal. That's nothing more to say. This is normal. This is normalcy. Just get used to it. That's all there is to do, is get used to it. It's that simple. So, no, we're not going to try to hunt the coyotes down. We're not going to try to go investigate them. Everything. They're over there. You know, that's fine. Let them be over there. We're here. So let us be here. Not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So we open up the door on normalcy. There it is. And then we're just with the wow. Nothing else to say. It's like freedom is freedom. Wow. Freshness is freshness. Reality is reality. Isness is isness. It comes from itself. It doesn't come from anywhere else other than itself. Normalcy is upon us, and that's what's happening. Normalcy is upon us. We're getting ready for that. See, the thing about normalcy and freshness is it stays fresh. And this is what gets to us. This is what begins to build up a wow in us. And this is what our all our expectations, all our thoughts, everything, gradually begin to be activated and say, hey, wait a minute. This is a little past time for it to start wearing off here. It's not wearing off. It's not diminishing. And that's when the alarm bells start going off, you know, the wow bells start going off. That's why when people cut it short, contemplation short, that doesn't work. You have to stay long blocks of time until you realize that the insight remains, the clarity remains, and that's when it really hits you. You say, oh my gosh, I'm able to stay with this all this time. It's still true. And then it reaches this wow, and suddenly you start, the reaction comes. You say, wow, this is still true. Whereas if you just glimpse it and say, okay, it's true now, and then you say, well, it's probably not going to be true later, I'm not going to hang around to find out, then it never reached a wow point. So it's those who stick around for the wow point to be triggered in them. That's when those are the ones that make the real progress, the real transition to normalcy. Because they feel it. Oh, this is permanent. This is not of this world. This is. And then their entire belief system is being challenged and crumbling. Belief in specialness is crumbling. And they say, well, we won't have anywhere to project guilt in, but we don't need to project guilt because we're forgiven. There's nothing to forgive. It's just a silly escapade. Didn't cause any harm. So we just decide to be normal. There's no more guilt. It's that simple. When it lasts, there's no more guilt, you see, because it means there's freedom. The freshness, inherent freshness of freedom is there. So there is no more guilt. You feel the way you feel normal. And since then you feel normal, you don't have any guilt, you don't need to project any guilt, so you don't need to get rid of freedom. You don't need death, time, space, process, and form to project guilt on. You don't need it. So, just stay with it. People went to see that these normal spirit, spirits in the past, wow, the pressure and the intensity they're under, just, you know, trying to bear it, and it starts so sinking in, hey, this is not going away, this is like freshness from freshness. And the wow strikes them. And then what you have to do is just say, fine, the wow's striking me, great. But don't try to get rid of the wow, just full stop in the wow, just let it be there. You need to be like a spiritual professional, full stop in the wow, as we're trained to be professional, just like a musician. If you want to be in a really good band, you've got to be a professional, actually. You have to do a lot of things just right, not too much, not too little. You just have to know how it works, how to go about your business. That's a professional, they know how to go about their business. Here, we know how to go about our business. It's not luck, it's a tremendous amount of attention. Some people think they just fling themselves into it with enthusiasm and there should be a professional right away. No, it doesn't work that way. Not exactly like that. You have to really know your business so you can keep it steady, keep it professional. So we say the freshness is here. Yeah, the freshness is here. Yeah, there's no reaction to it that way. And the reaction is as it keeps staying fresh and staying fresh and staying fresh, then it gradually gets to that. So we understand that we're not going all cuckoo about the freshness is here. We know we can take a little bit of it, but that's not the point. We want to get to the wow of it. Like, wow, it's still here. Wow, it's still fresh. Because that's what the professional is all about. You don't faint, and start carrying on all the drama and all this kind of stuff. That's not for being a spiritual professional. Professionals expect to win. It's when they keep winning that starts getting difficult. How to stay even, how even keel, just allow the winning to keep continue. That's what really takes professionals and really builds professionalism. And then when you find out you're never going to lose again, that's a whole different story, right? That it will be, so look forward to that challenge. So we're not, you know, here for a quick contact high. We're here to see how long we can ride it out. And increase our ability to keep riding it out, keep riding it out, keep riding this wave of freshness. So this may be the most important step. When the door opens, you don't react to that so much. You just say, well, let's see how long I can keep the door open. That's all I'm really interested in. So, let's say, quote-unquote, you're enlightened, okay, whatever, awakened, whatever, just don't even respond to that at all. I'll just say, well, that's not really the point. The point is, how long can I stay awakened or awake? How long can I stay with it? That's the challenge. At this point, that's the challenge. Don't try to grab at anything. Grab a hold of it and bottle it. No, because it's freshness coming from freshness. It's the freshness of freshness. You don't need to bottle it, or it's not going to go away. It's not going to stop being fresh. So you don't have to try and grab a hold of anything or take pictures or try to remember. Say, oh yeah, I need to remember this. It might go away. No. That's not professional. What we do is we say, I know this is freshness coming from freshness. And it will always be fresh. So let's just find out, how long can I just stay with this? And just watch my mind and my reactions and just notice and see what I do good and what areas I need to improve upon, and just be aware, that's all. Because it's just normalcy. This is what I'm transitioning to, so just see how well I can transition to it. Normalcy isn't going anywhere. We don't need to try to put it in a cage. So at this point, it's not like, well, I had a peak experience in such and such a day, such and such an hour, and for a little while I was enlightened, and wow. Now, at this point, we're past that. Not even interested in that. Not interested in peak experiences anymore. Because we're going back to normalcy to stay, so we don't need to catalog, oh, I had a peak experience in this or whatever. We're going back to stay. So we're going to get all of it. It's just a matter of getting used to it, that's all. That's all. this world really is. It's like a love-hate affair with this world. It's such an expression of creativity, yet it's also an expression of specialness and time and stuckness and all this kind of stuff. It's love-hate sort of thing. It's both there. You just see a little insect here, and wow. We put so much work into this projection, so much work into this belief system. So you can't help but feel some love for ourselves, for our creativity. Even though it's extremely weird, and yet, it's all the touches that we've gone to. So many details. So, the transition we're making towards normalcy, once we understand that now. So, like the animal you've been looking this for so long to show up in the jungle, you're looking, and there it is. Camera, I saw it. No cameras, no reaction, anything like that. Just the animal shows up, we just don't say anything, don't even react, so the animal's there. All we're interested in is how long is the animal going to stay, and how long are we going to stay looking at it. That's all we care about. And a watch pot never boils, so we're not going to try to keep track of time or anything. We're just going to just let it be the way it is, and see what we can do. So if Jesus shows up right beside me, I'm just gonna sit here and say, okay, Jesus is here, okay, and just see how long I can stay in that fact and acceptance, and that's it. Let's see if I can just stay calm about it for an hour, 2 hours, 3, 4, a day, I don't know, just see how long I can go. That's it. Because that's what's important. See, we're transitioning to normalcy, where we're going to be normal always. So that's all we're interested in is to keep increasing the how long we can stay with that normalcy before the wow just gets to be too much for us. So this is sort of the leap that I've been talking about. I've already succeeded in realizing that I don't need to succeed. We're no longer interested in that breakthrough. We're saying, no, I'm already here with it. You know, it's we're not trying to capture a moment, capture a breakthrough, anything like that anymore. So there's a much more blasé, relaxed attitude. No, I'm already here with enlightenment. I'm already enlightened that I don't need to be. I'm already successfully enlightened. I know I'm already successfully enlightened, and I don't need to become successfully enlightened. So it's not a matter like, I finally became successfully enlightened. That's not it. No. I know I'm already successfully enlightened. It's a matter of how long can I accept this fact? How long can I accept I'm already normal? I know that I'm already successfully normal. I don't have to become successfully normal. So just how long can I keep accepting this fact? I know I'm already successfully normal. I know I'm already enlightened. I know I know already that Jesus is successfully here, for instance. Like, when did you get here? Oh my gosh. No, I know you're, I know, I already know Jesus is successfully here. It's just how long can I stay accepting of that? This is a trick in transitioning, the leap over that gap. That's what we've been working on. And it's bearing fruit right now, and it's maturing. And those who are not professional, all they want to know is, really, Jesus? Wait, when? What time? What day? What time? What hour? What exactly? Can you tell me the minute, the second? I mean, what was your impression? I mean, when you know, what was your impression? What was your reaction? What, they want to turn it into a peak experience, just an experience. Not interested in any of that anymore. That's unprofessional. We're only interested in how long can we stay with it? And we're thinking like large amounts of time here. So the minutes don't matter. How long is it? A day or two or whatever, you know, this is a couple days, maybe a couple weeks or whatever. Something like that. I don't care exact minute or moment Jesus showed up, so as if it was like a snapshot, like an image. We're not taking images of it. I mean, a little while ago, I don't know, it doesn't matter. So this is an obvious difference between the unprofessional and the professional, spiritual, unprofessional. Obvious difference. Most people are unprofessional. You know, they're unprofessional. You know, you can say something like, "Well, I had this peak experience," and they don't want to pin you down to details. So the time is turning into an image. Just one snap in time, like that. And then they say, "Okay, I'm relaxed with it because it didn't last. I've now compartmentalized it into a mental image." So you don't say, "Well, I'm enlightened." No, I know I'm already successfully enlightened. I already know that. I know I'm already successfully enlightened. What I'm interested in is staying with it. So we've changed our attitude. This is a tremendous change of attitude. This is why I've been working so diligently on this. I know I'm on the other side already. I'm not worried, when did I arrive on the other side? My concern is, how long can I stay on this other side? You know, how long can I stay here? I don't care about what's the exact moment I stepped here, and how did it feel when I first stepped here, and blah, blah, blah. That's ridiculous. Maybe the freshness is still fresh. I'm concerned, how long can I stay with this freshness that is freshness coming from freshness? You know, like a great band, they know they're gonna kick it the whole night. At least they're gonna try. They're not out there just to do one hit song and everyone goes, "Wow!" And they're gonna go, "Wow, we did this great hit song." No, they know the whole set is just gonna be tremendous. And they're focused on how tremendous can we make the entire thing. Yeah, that's it. And see, at some point, great bands, the audience realizes, they're going to be great all the way through, and at some point it hits you that they may think, "Oh, they did a hit song. That's nice. That's wonderful. Next song's even better, 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 better." And then you just start saying, "Oh my gosh, I'm just going to be. This music is just going to keep coming and coming and better. Oh my gosh, wow!" And that's when the wow factor hits you. And that's a whole different game. You say, "Oh my gosh, they're able to do that like this all the way through." Well, wow. That's So again, we're hanging out until the wow factor really kicks in. Then we're trying to stick with it and, you know, get used to full stopping the wow and then let it build again and keep going. That's what we're hanging out for. And it's my surmise, reasonable surmise, that that's when the freshness arrives, when you have that professional attitude. That's what it's waiting for. Well, you know, we've been trying to get this freshness, a lot of people in the world, but we've been pretty unprofessional about it. And this has been very humbling. I haven't succeeded in 37 years. And I keep saying, well, it's whose fault is it? And I keep saying, well, it must be my fault. It must be lacking in something. And so I keep asking the Holy Spirit, what's wrong? How come? I know it's there, but it just doesn't show itself. And why? And, you know, I have to realize it's my shortcoming, my unprofessionalism. It's not the Holy Spirit's fault. It's not the freshness's fault. It's not normalcy's fault. But sometimes you sure feel like, you know, you want to blame it on that, because if I've done everything I can possibly do and I'm still nothing. Wow. So you just have to keep paying attention here. And that's all we're trying to do, is just let as many people as possible, let as many of us as possible, spirits as possible, who are transitioning to normal, back to normal, setting down the belief in specialness, to just be able to get this experience of wow, and let them keep working on full stop on the wow. That's the discipline, that's what we have to work on. That's it. So that's the only goal, is just make it available, make it possible for those who want to work on this to work on this. That's all. There isn't any other goal. We're not going to say, okay, now we did it, let's stop and let's go write, you know, promote, write a book, do this. Not at this juncture at all. You know, that's, we're not going to turn it into an image, a story. No, it's happening. You know, it won't be happening right now. And that means we're in the wow, and we're dealing with the wow of it. So this is sort of like graduation time. It's not time to fool around with other stuff. Are there only a few who can do this, or a lot? I think there are many, once they understand what it is they're doing. It's silent, full stop in the wow, allowing them this feeling to, they realize, oh my gosh, this isn't going away. I mean, this is here, it's not going away, it's not diminishing. And to feel that wow, and this challenges all my beliefs, my expectations, this is more than I expected, wow. And then just say, you know what, I'm just going to not try to spin this wow at all. I'm just going to stay with it. Once we understand that, I think a lot of us will say, let's do that. This is great use of the time. Super great use of time. Because really everybody's going to be dealing with some sort of wow. Why not have it deal with the wow in relation to freshness, staying fresh, instead of the wow of all the grotesque, horrible things that the world news has to bring you and the various troubles to come. That will get a wow in you too, because you say, wow, I don't think I can handle anything so terrible. This is terrible, wow. And you'll be going a wow in the direction of terribleness. Death, time, unfreshness, you know, specialness, lack of freedom, specialness, sickness, death, all that. That will be a wow for you. So you're going to have a wow one way or the other. You might as well have a wow, folk discipline on, wow, the freshness is remaining fresh. I didn't expect that. It could remain fresh this long. Wow. This is just like, I don't know, can't explain it. This is just amazing. But I am transitioning to normalcy, so that's great. I'm just going to write it out. So this is the option. Everyone's going to be dealing with the wow, but it depends in relation to what? It's a choice. It's the option. There's really no very little fence to sit on, you know, at this time, is there? Going forward, you will find the fence crumbling, and you will be in some wow situation. And those who want to be spiritual professionals, they turn to, okay, full stop on the wow of the freshness that comes from freshness, that is just ever fresh, the ever freshness. Wow. That's a wonderful wow. It's a wonderful wow. Do, 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 do. I think I'll stay inside for a while and just enjoy the wow, 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 wow. Yeah. Just enjoy that clean, fresh freshness. The clean, fresh freshness. It's even fresher than air. It's even fresher than fresh air. It's clean, fresh freshness. Feeling it everywhere. So transition to normalcy, trying to transition to normalcy. Yes, you can. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. You're going to have to choose your wow very soon. Choose your wow. Alright, so all prayers, expectations, thankfulness, gratitude to the freshness in anticipation that it will show up here. And in fact, we can say, I know it's already, the freshness has already successfully shown up here. I know already that the freshness, that the freshness has successfully arrived. And already that the freshness has successfully arrived. I don't need for the freshness to successfully arrive. I know it's already successfully arrived. I know it's already successfully arrived. So put us in the feeling like, you know, it's already here. This is a done deal. Contract has already been signed. It is a done deal. It's showing up. I saw an old friend today that's been on the spiritual path their whole life. They're old, very old. And they've worked so hard at it, so hard at it, so never giving up so diligently. I used to spend some time with them when I was young. And, you know, they're still hanging in there. They're still trying. You know, just wow. It would be great for them to have this option, they'll have an option to just, you know, just sit quietly and feel the wow of the wow. But, you know, that would just be tremendous. There are people like that. So I was happy to see them. Didn't say much, just how are you, and that's all. And I just say, we deserve it. We deserve it. Absolutely, we deserve it. And so we have to feel that we've already successfully got it. We've already successfully got it. It's already successfully arrived. I know the freshness has already successfully arrived. Contract's already been signed. It's here. I know it's already here. I know it's already successfully arrived. It's already successfully here. Put ourselves beyond the expectation of arriving. Know it's already arrived. So we don't have to catalog, this catalog its arrival. We're not reporters reporting on its arrival. It's already arrived. It's too late for that. Now we're just interested in how long we can stay with it. That's all. That's all. So again, all prayers and blessings to everyone that this will be beneficial to all of us, and just to put ourselves that it's already or successfully arrived, and feel that it's too late to worry about its arrival. It's already arrived. You know, that's like some great politician or social famous person, whatever, saint or whatever. You expect them to come, they're going to stay in your guest house or stay in the hotel downtown or somewhere near close by, and even thinking about their arrival, like, when are they going to get here? You're all hyped up about that, and then someone tells you, what do you mean, when are they going to get there? They're already here. That totally changes everything, doesn't it? It's a whole different attitude. They're already here. So then that's when you find out, you know, are you going to sit with them, meet with them or not? Because before you said, oh, sure I will. As soon as they get here, they just haven't got here yet. I'm waiting for them to get here. But no, they're already here. Freshness has already successfully arrived. It's already here. This is a totally different scenario. Okay, so this is what we're focusing on. This is where success will be found. This is where professionalism is found. So don't say, when is Jesus coming? Say, no, what do you mean? He's already here. I know Jesus is already here. You know, so look at it that way. However you want to symbolize the freshness that comes from freshness, it's already here. Says it hasn't made any big deal about it being here, that means it's only interested in how long can you stick with it. It's not interested in some just a little epiphany that you may have. This is serious business now. So, you know, we can't say, well, why didn't you tell us when you got here? We would have come with bells and whistles and flowers and balloons and had a photo op and got in the paper and told everybody and blah, 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 blah. And now it's like, you've already been here. We can't do that. So what can we do? Wow, I guess we just got to sit here, huh? Just imagine the scenario that what you're waiting for has already been here, just waiting for you. It hasn't made any big deal or announcement or any splash at all. It means that you can't do that because you try to stake big deals. What do you mean? I've already been here for quite some time. Don't waste your time on that. Let's get down to business here. So we pre-stress ourselves with this professional expectations, expecting professionalism of us as if the situation is already here where we have to be true spiritual professionals. And this really helps us ease into it for sure. Tremendous technique here to do it like this. Okay, very great. Keep working at this, keep working at it, because this is what it's all about, okay? That's it.